Hello everybody, so today we will be doing the lower Tumerian Labyrinth. This is going to be part one of it. I'm going to do the first half of it, and then I'll do the second half later. So, there is going to be a side room right here. We're going to go up ahead and get the lamp first. Just be careful when going into this room. Okay, so we're gonna encounter a new type of enemy. These are, I think they're called like Tumerian Knights or something. But this one wields basically a great sword. We'll need 9 of those. Alright, so up ahead, I think we're gonna, so this thing that's on screen, Workshop Hazen Extractor, we're gonna be getting that in this dungeon. Alright, so keep an eye up above. There's going to be spiders that will fall down from the ceiling. Like here. Pretty easy to take out, just... just like that. Like I said, pretty easy to take out. Open up the shortcut. So I think I'll go to blood level 125 or maybe 150. I think 150 because... whoa, I didn't think he would be able to hit me there. If you farm them, they will drop, I forget what it's called. I think it's like, something backbone. Ooh, nice. 18%. So there are going to be four layers on this dungeon. Layer 1 boss, I think, I don't remember what it was. Probably something really easy. Layer 2 was those guys, Merciless Watchers. Layer 3 is going to be Rom. And then layer 4 is going to be a new boss. Oh, keep an eye out right there. Oh, those guys can also drop pebbles. I didn't know that. That was easy. Oh, nice, a secret. Actually, no, Layer 1 boss was the Merciless Watchers. Layer 2, I think, is going to be either Keeper of the Old Lords or something different. So there are also these like things called false steps to chalice dungeons, which basically are hacked dungeons that allow me to get way better like runes and like weapons and stuff like that way earlier than I'm supposed to. But there are like some runes in there that can really help me, like a better health rune and a better clawmark rune and stuff like that. But I don't want to do that because I feel use that because I feel like that's kind of cheating in a way. So I just won't be doing that, at least until I complete all the chalice dungeons. Oh no. Okay, I know what layer 2 is gonna be. It's gonna be a new variant of Undead Giant, but this one's gonna be even more bullshit. So, this Undead Giant is gonna have chains. And in phase 2, those chains will swing around and it can pretty much one-shot you if you aren't careful enough. Get out. Get out. Get out. Sorry, my dad just came in here. Yeah, so it can almost one-shot you. Alright, now this is where it's gonna get a little bit bullshit. So, his swing attack that he will do now... will swing all those around, and that will one-shot you if you don't have enough health. Yeah, so as you can see, kind of bullshit boss. So, you know what? I'm gonna go back, buy some things, and then we'll go back at it. We can honestly just farm for those later. I can just sell them all right now. Yeah, it was a yellow backbone. That's what those Dumerian Knight enemies will drop. Yeah, we completed all the Hinder Tomb Chalice dungeons, so we don't need those bloodshot eyeballs anymore. Alright, let's try again. Alright, let's take this fucker down. That's his grab attack. Don't get near him when he does it. You will get one-shotted by it. Sangua Felinci de Opesia to me. There we go. Man, that guy was a challenge, but we got him. Alright, so let's head back, get some more things, and then we'll do that side room, and then that'll be it for part one. I don't need that. Alright, let's see. Is there anything else we can get now that we beat him? We can get a bloodstone chunk. Don't really need that right now. We'll get way more of those later. Put that away. Actually, you know what? I'll just get the level I need now so I don't have to waste my blood echoes.
Welcome. Very well.
Okay.
Farewell, good hunt.
No, I'll just sell my Chikage. I don't need it right now. I mean, I just bought it with 50,000 souls, but I mean, I don't really need it, so.
Well, what? Very well. Farewell.
Okay, I'm not sure what there's gonna be. Alright, so this side room is where we're gonna get the arcane haze extractor tool. Alright, so that chest way up there, that will be our arcane haze extractor tool. Man, that's a bit loud. I'm gonna turn down the sound effects pretty low so I don't blow my goddamn ears out. What a dumb bitch. Just blow yourself up, yeah. Dumbass. Alright, so I don't think... Okay, there's gonna be cannons up there, right? Alright, there we go. Now none of them can fire the cannons. We'll be safe from that at least. Nope, we're not, but... We're still out of range of it, so it'll be fine. Workshop haze extractor. So I'll head back and show you how this thing works. Then that will be it for this part. So let's head down to the next layer just so I can get the next lamp so I can just go down there whenever I need to. Alright. Alright, so head up to your upgrade station. Go down to Arcane Haze. We scrapped out various ritual materials. Materials are arcane haze, an essential material for certain chalice rituals. So, to explain how this works quickly, let's say there's Sage's Wrist. You don't need anymore. You can take into your arcane haze and use it, and you'll get some arcane haze out of it. Which arcane haze is needed for the Great Iz Chalice and the Sinister Chalices. Which they will automatically spawn Bell Maidens. So that's going to be it for part 1 of this dungeon. I'll be doing part 2 probably tomorrow because it's getting a little bit late. So, see ya.